Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this preview performance of Sunset Boulevard. May we remind you that the use of cameras and recording equipment is forbidden. Thank you.
I guess it was 5 a.m. A homicide had been reported from one of those crazy mansions up on Sunset. Tomorrow, every front page is going to lead with the story. You see, an old-time movie star is involved. Maybe the biggest star of all. But before you read about it, before it gets distorted by those Hollywood piranhas, if you want to know the real facts, you've come to the right party. Let me take you back 6 months. I was at the bottom of the barrel. I'd had a contract back at Fox, but I'd fallen foul of Darryl. No, I had a date at Paramount, along with about 1,000 other writers. If this didn't come up roses, I'd be covering funerals back in Dayton, Ohio. I'd hidden my car 3 blocks away. Turned out to be a smart move. Yeah, I got an appointment with Mr. Sheldrake.
Name?
Gillis. Joseph Gillis.
Okay, sir. You know your way?
Yeah. Hi there, Myron.
How's it hanging?
I've got a date with Sheldrake.
I'm shooting a western down at...
How can you work with Darryl?
We should talk.
Gotta run, let's have lunch.
Hi, Mr. Gillis.
You look great.
I'm up for an audition.
Sheldrake is driving me insane.
Don't forget me when you cast.
We should talk.
Gotta run,
let's have lunch. Morning, Joanna.
Hi there, Myra. How are you doing?
How's it hanging?
I've got a date with Sheldrake.
I'm up for an audition.
I'm shooting a western down at Fox.
I'd really love to read it.
Don't forget me when you're here.
We should talk.
We should talk.
Run.
Let's have lunch.
We want the keys to your car.
You're way behind with the payments.
Don't give us any fancy footwork.
Give us the keys.
I only wish I could help. I loaned it to my accountant. He has an important client down in Palm Springs. Felt like playing some golf.
Are you telling us you walked here?
I believe in self-denial. I'm in training for the priesthood.
Okay, wise guy, $300.
Oh, we're taking your car.
We got a court order.
I love it when you talk dirty.
Eat show!
Hi there, Mary.
Where have you been hiding?
How you doing?
What are you shooting?
Riding for Betty Hutton.
Trying to make my mind.
I'm up to something real.
Why don't you ever call me back?
Should you undo a button?
Hey, isn't that your agent?
We should talk.
We should talk.
Let's have lunch.
Greetings, Gillis. What brings you here?
You're the one who fixed the date.
Make it quick, don't keep us waiting. We're with Sheldrake 1015.
Who is this?
He's my new boy. I have a play on Broadway.
In verse, every major studio.
Hey, listen now. I need $200.
He's always been a joker.
Okay, how about 100? I really need some money.
Maybe what you need is a new agent.
Love scene.
Bless you, Joseph. That you, Sammy.
How do you like my hair up?
How come you get such lousy breaks?
One learns to grin and bear up.
This is the biggest film ever made.
What are you playing?
Gentle Virgin.
Let's have lunch. Hello, Artie.
Joe, you bastard!
You never call me anymore.
Found a cuter dancing partner. How are things?
Not so great.
Will this help?
Thanks. You're a pal. I'll pay you back.
When you sign your contract. Morning, Mr. DeMille.
Good morning, Mr. DeMille.
Hiya,
morning,
CB.
Mr. DeMille. Morning, Mr. DeMille.
Morning, Mr. DeMille.
Morning, Mr. DeMille.
Good morning, Mr. DeMille. Morning, Mr. DeMille.
I just love Hollywood.
Give me that shithead, Nolan. Nolan, sweetheart, great to talk. I read your script this morning. It won't work.
Mr. Gillis.
It won't work. Who needs lunch?
Joe, what the hell brings you here?
You wanted to see me.
I did? Any idea about what?
I sent you an outline.
You did? I never saw it. Nobody tells me anything.
Bases loaded. It's a baseball story.
So pitch.
Okay, it's about a rookie shortstop. Batting 347.
Uh-huh.
Poor kid was once mixed up in a holdup. Now he's trying to go straight. Only...
Wait a minute. I think I have read this. Can somebody bring in whatever we have on...
Bases loaded.
Bases loaded. So they tell the poor kid he's got to throw the World Series, am I right?
Pretty hot for it over 20th.
Good.
Nah, I don't trust Zanuck. I mean, can you see Ty Power as a shortstop? You got the best man for it right on the lot. Alan Ladd.
Here's that bases loaded material, Mr. Sheldrake. I made a 2-page synopsis of it for you, but I wouldn't bother to read it.
Why not?
It was just a rehash of something that wasn't very good to begin with.
Meet Mr. Gillis. He wrote it. This is Miss Kramer.
Schaefer. Betty Schaefer. And right now I'd like to crawl into a hole and pull it in after me.
If I could be of any help.
I'm sorry, Mr. Gillis. I couldn't see the point of it. I think pictures should at least try to say a little something.
Oh, I see. You're one of the message kids. I expect you to have turned down Gone with the Wind.
No, that was me.
And I guess I was disappointed. I've read some of the stories you wrote for the magazines, and I thought you had some real talent.
It was last year. This year I felt like eating.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Gillis.
Yeah, well, next time I'll write you The Naked and the Dead.
That'll be all, Miss Kramer. Well, looks like Xanax got himself a baseball picture.
Look, have you got any kind of work?
There's nothing, honest. Of course, we're always looking for a Betty Hutton script. What if we made it a girls' softball team? Put in a few numbers, might make a cute musical.
What, are you trying to be funny? Because I'm all out of laughs. I'm over a barrel. I need a job. Additional dialogue, anything at all.
Well, something may come up. I'll keep you in mind.
Listen, Mr. Sheldrake, could you give me $300 as a personal loan? See, I've been grinding out original stories 2 a week for months now. Maybe they're not original enough. Maybe they're too original.
The finest things in the world have been written on an empty stomach.
It's not my stomach I'm worried about. It's my car. If I lose that in this town, it's like getting my legs cut off.
Gillis, last year somebody talked me into buying a ranch in the valley. So I borrowed the money. Yeah? Okay, put them on. This year I had to mortgage the ranch so I could keep up my life insurance payments. He wants to see who? Brando? Brando, take it from me. Nobody wants to see that kid.
Huh. Come to get your knife back? It's still here, right between my shoulder blades.
You wrote a story a couple of years back about a teacher titled something to do with windows.
Yeah, blind window.
I really liked it.
You're making me feel all warm and runny inside.
Maybe I can get Sheldrake to auction it.
I doubt it. He likes pictures with great weather and happy endings.
Why don't you let me try? Let's get together.
That's what they all say.
I'll be at Schwab's on Thursday. I'm always there around 6 o'clock.
I've gotta check my diary.
We should talk.
Gotta run.
What's the rush?
See these gorillas?
Yes, what about them?
Do me a terrific favor. Keep them amused while I escape.
If you agree to Thursday.
Done.
There he is. Come and show us where you parked it,
or I'll reshape your face.
Oh, please be quiet. Mr. DeMille is shooting through there.
So what?
Well, he's working on one of Hetty's red hot scenes and Samson and Delilah. Do you guys want to go on the set?
I no. think we maybe have 5 minutes.
Lovely sight. A A great big empty garage. This thing must burn up to 10 gallons to a mile. There had to be a house around here someplace, but the garden was so neglected and overgrown, I couldn't for the moment figure out where it was. At the same time, I felt cold all of a sudden, you know? As if someone was walking over my grave. Where am I? I had landed in the driveway of some palazzo, like an abandoned movie set.
You there! Why are you so late?
This way.
Hey, listen, buddy.
And wipe your feet. My help with the coffin, call me.
You know, wait a minute. Hey.
Any laws against burying him in the garden?
I wouldn't know.
I don't care anyway. No more wars to fight, white flags fly tonight. You are out of danger now. Battlefield is still, wild poppies on the hill. Peace can only come when you tracers fly, lighting up the sky, but a fight on to the end. Let them send their armies, I will never bend. I won't see you now till I
Now, don't you give me a fancy price just because I'm rich.
Lady, you've got the wrong man. I had some trouble with my car. I just pulled into your driveway.
Get out!
Okay. And I'm sorry you lost your friend.
Get out of here!
I'm sorry, but... Haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Or shall I call my servant?
Aren't you Norma Desmond? You used to be in pictures. You used to be big.
I am big. It's the pictures that got small. There was a time in this business, you would remember, we had the eyes of the whole wide world. But that wasn't good enough for those Einsteins in the front office. They wanted the ears of the world as well. So they took all the idols and smashed them. The Fairbanks, the Gilberts, the Valentinos. They trampled on what was divine. They threw away the gold of silence when all they needed was this face of mine.
No, don't blame me. I'm just a writer.
Watch me when I frown. You can't write that down. You know I'm right. It's there in black and white. When I look your way, you'll hear what I say. Yes, with one look, I put words to shame. Just one look sets the screen aflame. Silent music starts to play. One tear in my eye makes the whole world cry. With one look, they'll forgive the past. They'll rejoice I've returned at last to my people in the dark. Still out there the dark. Silent music starts to play. With one look, you'll know all you need to know. With one look, I'll go.
Well, next time I'll bring my autograph album. Or maybe a hunk of cement and ask for your footprint.
Just a minute. Did you say you were a writer?
That's what it says in my guild card.
And you've written pictures?
Sure have. Would you like to see my credits?
Come over here. I want to ask you something. What sort of length is a movie script these days?
Yeah, that depends.
I wrote this. It's a very important picture.
Looks like six very important pictures.
It's for DeMille to direct.
Uh-huh. And will you be in it?
Of course. What did you think?
Just asking. I didn't know you're planning a comeback.
I hate that word. It's a return.
Fair enough.
I want you to read it.
You shouldn't let another writer read your stuff. He may steal it.
I'm not afraid. Sit down. Max! Bring something to drink.
Yes, madame.
I said, sit down. It's about Salome. Salome, the story of a woman. The woman who was all women. Salome, what a woman, what a part. Innocent body and a sinful heart. Inflaming Herod's lust, but secretly loving a holy man. Nobody can play her like I can.
Well, I had nothing urgent coming up. I thought I might as well skim it. It's fun to see how bad, bad writing can be. This promise to go to the limits.
There's so many great scenes, I can't wait. A boiling cauldron of love and hate. She toys with Herod till his body in her hands. He rears tormented through the desert sands.
It sure was a real cheery setup. The wind wheezing through that organ. Max shuffling around in a dead ape dumped on a shelf. And her staring like a gorgon.
They drag a Baptist up from the jails. She dances the dance of the seven veils. Herod says, I'll give you anything.
Now it was time for some comedy relief. The guy with the baby casket must have seen a thing or two, that chimp. Shame it was too late to ask it.
Have you got to the scene where she asks for his head? If she can't have him living, she'll take him dead. They bring in his head on a silver tray. She kisses his mouth, it's a great scream.
Got to be 11, I was feeling ill.
What the hell was I doing?
Melodrama and sweet champagne. And a garbled plot from a scrambled brain. But I had my own plot brewing. Just how old is Salome?
16.
I see.
Well?
It's fascinating.
Of course it is!
Could be it's a little long. Maybe the opening's wrong, but it's extremely good for a beginner.
No, it's a perfect start. I wrote that with my heart. The riverbank, the Baptist, and the sinner.
Shouldn't there be some dialogue?
I can say anything I want with my eyes.
We could use a few cuts.
I will not have it butchered. tortured.
I'm not talking limb from limb. I just mean a little trim. All you need is someone who can edit.
I want someone with a knack, not just any studio hack. And don't think for a moment I'd share credit. When were you born?
December 21st. Why?
I like Sagittarians. You can trust them.
Thanks.
I want you to do this work.
Me? Geez, I don't know. I'm busy. I just finished one script and, I'm about to start a new assignment.
I don't care.
I'm pretty expensive. I get $500 a week.
Don't worry about money. I'll make it worth your while.
Well, it's getting kind of late.
Are you married, Mr.?
Name is Gillis. Single.
Where do you live?
Hollywood. Alto Nido Apartments.
You'll stay here.
I'll come back early tomorrow.
Nonsense. There's a room over the garage. Max will take you there. Max!
Yes, madame.
Take Mr. Gillis to the guest room. We'll begin at 9 sharp.
Now this is more like it.
I made the bed up this afternoon.
Well, thanks. How did you know I was gonna stay?
There's soap and a toothbrush in the bathroom.
Say, she's quite a character, isn't she? That Norma Desmond.
Remember, if you said Hollywood, hers was the face you'd think of, her face on every billboard. In just a single week, she'd get 10,000 letters. Fortunes for a bloom from her corsage, for a few strands from her hair. Today she's half forgotten, but it's the pictures that got small. She is the greatest star of all. Ben, you can't imagine the way fans sacrifice themselves to touch her shadow. There was a Maharaja who hanged himself with one of her discarded stockings. She's immortal, caught inside that flickering light beam, is a youth which cannot fade. Madame's a living legend. I've seen so many idols fall. She is the greatest star of all.
When he'd gone, I stood looking out of the window a while. There was a ghost of a tennis court with faded markings and a sagging net. There was an empty pool where Clara Bow and Fatty Arbuckle must have swum 10,000 midnights ago. And then there was something else. The chimp's last rites. As if she were laying a child to rest. Was her life really as empty as that?
Never thought it could happen like this. Saw myself as the Jewish Casanova. But as soon as we shared our first kiss, I knew all my romancing days were over. Now I'm up in the clouds and I'm head over heels. I know it sounds corny, but that's how it feels.
That's great. Is there any chance of meeting this paragon?
Sure, just for a minute. She's due to have a meeting with some poor struggling hack.
Mr. Gillis.
Oh, you two know each other?
Yeah. I'm the hack.
Oh, I'm sorry. And she's the smartass.
Just a minute. You're leaving me way behind
here. Yeah, don't worry. We better have our meeting. I don't want to come between you two lovebirds a minute longer than I have to. May I?
Of course.
Oh, and congratulations. He tells me you've made a new man of him. And you've done pretty well, I'd say. Of course, she could use a little guidance in the literary appreciation department.
I like blind windows.
That's why I'm here.
So, have you had any ideas about how you could turn it into a movie?
Girl meets boy. That's a safe beginning.
Is this a Western? I love those wide rolling plains.
No, it's not. They live in the city.
Then it's a thriller. The sidewalk gleams when it rains. Or how about a brilliant pianist? Every time the full moon's on the rise, he can't play without a shot of virgin's blood.
Thanks a lot. Be sure to leave your number.
You'll think of something. I'll see you opening night.
Girl meets boy, now if I remember, she's a young teacher, he's a reporter, it's hate at first sight.
It won't sell, these days they want glamour. Fabulous heiress meets handsome Hollywood heel. Problem is, she thinks he's a dentist. Would you believe it? A wedding in the last reel.
It doesn't have to be so mindless. You should write from your experience. Give us something really moving, something true.
Who wants true? Who the hell wants moving?
moving means starving, and true means holes in your shoe.
No, you're wrong. They still make good pictures. Stick to your story. It's a good story.
Okay, Miss Schaefer, I give it to you.
What do you mean?
Just what I said. It's all yours.
I've given up writing myself, so you write it.
But I'm not good enough to do it on my own. I thought we could write it together.
Can't. I'm all tied up.
Well, couldn't we work evenings? 6 o'clock in the morning. I'll come to your place.
Betty, it can't be done. It's out.
Well, let's keep in touch through Artie. That way, if you get stuck, we can at least talk. I've always been very liberal with advice. Write this down. I'll give you some ground rules. Plenty of conflict. But nice guys don't break the law. Girl meets boy, gives herself completely. And though she loves him, she keeps one foot on the floor.
No one dies except the best friend. No one ever mentions communists. No one takes a black friend to a restaurant.
Very good. Nothing I can teach you. We could have had fun fighting the studio.
Yes, Mr. Gillis, that's just what I want.
Hey, you're not going, are you? Come to the movies with us.
No, I was just explaining to Betty I've given up the movies.
Well, will we see you New Year's Eve? My place, same as ever?
Oh, yeah, sure. As long as you promise there'll be a lot of bad behavior.
Guaranteed the worst in town.
Mr. Gillis.
Good luck.
Where have you been?
Out. I assume I can go out when I feel like it.
Madame is very agitated. Earlier this evening, she wanted you for something, but you could not be found.
Well, that's tough.
I don't think you understand, Mr. Gillis. Madame is extremely fragile. She has moments of melancholy.
Why? Because of her career? She's done well enough. Look at all the fan mail she gets every day.
I wouldn't look too closely at the postmarks if I were you.
You mean you send them?
Will you be requiring any supper this evening, sir?
No. And Max?
Yes, sir.
Who the hell do you think you are, huh? Bringing my stuff over from my apartment without consulting me? I have a life of my own! And now you're telling me I'm supposed to be a prisoner here?
I think so. Perhaps you will have to make up your mind to abide by the rules of this house. That is, if you want this job.
I started work on the script. I hacked my way through the thicket. A maze of fragmented ramblings by a soul in limbo. She hovered there like a hawk, afraid I'd damage her baby. The house was always so quiet. Just me and Max and that organ. No one phoned and nobody ever came. I couldn't breathe in that room. It was so full of Norma Desmond. And there was only one kind of entertainment on hand.
Joan of Arc, look at my face, isn't it strong? There in the dark, up on the screen where I belong, we'll show them all nothing has changed. We'll give the world new ways to dream. Everyone needs new ways to dream.
I didn't argue, why hurt her? You don't yell at her, sleepwalker, or she could fall and break her neck. She smelled of faded roses, it made me sad to watch her as she relived her glory. Poor Norma, so happy, lost in her silver heaven.
December, the rains came. One great big package. Oversized, like everything else in California. It came right through the roof of my room above the garage. So she had me move to the main house, to what Max called the room of the husbands. On a clear day, the theory was you could see Catalina. And little by little, I worked through to the end of the script. At which point I might have left. Only by then, those two boys from the finance company had traced my car and towed it away.
Stop that! Today's the day.
What do you mean?
Max is going to deliver the script to Paramount.
You're really gonna give it to DeMille?
I've just spoken with my astrologer. She read DeMille's horoscope, she read mine.
Did she read the script?
DeMille is Leo, I am Scorpio. Mars is transiting Jupiter, and today is the day of closest conjunction.
Ah, well, that's all right then.
Max! Make sure it goes to Mr. DeMille in person.
Yes, madame.
Well.
Great day.
It's been real interesting.
Yes, hasn't it?
I want to thank you for trusting me with your baby.
No, not at all. It is I who should thank you.
Will you call and let me know as soon as you have some news?
Call where?
My apartment.
You can't possibly think of leaving now, Joe.
The script is finished, Noma.
No, Joe! It's just the beginning. It's the first draft. I couldn't dream of letting you go. I need your support.
Norma.
No, you'll stay on full salary, of course.
It's not the money. It's... Look, of course, I'll wait until we get some sort of reaction from Paramount.
Thank you, Joe.
So Max climbed into that old foreign bus in the garage with its gold-plated car phones and leopard-skin upholstery and trundled down to Paramount to hand in our masterpiece. And I settled down to wait for the inevitable rejection.
Do the rest. I brought nothing but the best. You're a very lucky right to come along. Now get undressed. Unless I'm much mistaken, that's a 42-inch chest.
I don't understand a word you're saying.
Well, all you need to know is the lady's paying. It's nice to get your just reward this time of year.
Get out of here.
And all my merchandise is strictly kosher. When you've thrown away all your old worn-out stuff.
Hey, that's enough.
Perhaps you'd like to model for my brochure. I have just the thing for you. Chalk striped suits
in black
or blue. Lent back trousers.
Cashmere sweaters.
Bathing shorts for men in blue.
Here's a pad with leather lace on. It's a virtuoso shoe.
And a simply marvelous coat made out by Cuna.
You know what you can do with your vicuna.
Come on, Joe, you haven't even started yet.
You wanna bet?
I thought by now he'd look the height of fashion. He always takes forever making up his mind. Don't be unkind. I thought you writers knew about compassion. I love man, a lot of man.
This will compliment his tan.
We'll take two of these and four of them.
I'm still your greatest fan. Very soon now, we'll have stopped in looking like and also ran.
You're going to make me sorry that I'm staying.
Well, all right, I'll choose. After all, I'm paying.
Evening clothes.
I want to see your most deluxe.
Won't wear a tux.
Of course not, dear. Tuxedos are for waiters.
What we need are tails, a white tie, and top hat.
I can't wear that.
So second-rate clothes are for second-raters.
No, ma, please.
Shut up, I'm rich. Not some platinum blonde bitch. I own so many apartments. I've forgotten which is which. I own a house of another.
What a salesman, what a pitch.
Understand your game and I'm not playing.
Please don't spoil the fun I get from paying. Let me show you what clothes can do for a man.
Yeah.
display. You seem to forget that I'm a writer. Who cares what you wear when you're a writer?
I can't, Joe, and please don't be so mean to me.
Okay, all right.
You'll be Prince Charming at my New Year's party.
I've been invited somewhere else on New Year's Eve.
But that's our night.
I always see the New Year in with Artie.
I can't do without you, Joe. I need you. I've sent out every single invitation.
All right, Norma, I give in.
Of course you do. And when they dress you, you'll cause a sensation.
We equip the chosen few of movie land.
The latest cuts.
Keeps every movie star and crooner. From the shiny top hats to their hat bands.
Conceal your guts. You won't regret selecting the vicuna.
Shape. If there's a girl you want to make, if there's a soul you're out to capture, or a heart you want to break, if you want the world to love you,
you have to learn to take.
You must decide what part you are portraying.
And certain parts are worth the lady paying.
And why not have it all?
You know, I couldn't imagine what sort of a gallery of waxworks Norma had invited to her New Year's Eve party, but she'd certainly gone to town. I hadn't expected the place would look like Times Square. So, Max, I suppose half the guests will be in wheelchairs, will they?
I wouldn't know, sir. Madame has made all the arrangements.
Happy New Year.
Norma, I can't take this.
Oh, shut up. Open it. Read what it says.
Mad about the boy?
Yes. And you do look absolutely divine.
Well, thank you.
I had these tiles put in, you know, because Valentino said to me it takes tiles to tango. Come along.
Oh, no, no, not on the same floor as Valentino.
Just follow me. Back like that.
Well, it's that thing. It tickles.
If you're with me, next year will be
the perfect year.
Before we play some dangerous game, before we fan some harmless flame, we have to ask if this is wise and if the game is worth the prize. With this wine and with this music, how can anything be clear? Let's wait and see. It may just be the perfect year.
It's New Year's Eve and hopes are high. Dance one year in, kiss one goodbye. Another chance, another start. So many dreams to tease the heart. We don't need a crowded ballroom. Everything we want is here and face to face. We will embrace the perfect year. We don't need a crowded ballroom. Everything we want is here. And face to face, we will embrace the perfect.
What time are they supposed to get here?
Who?
The other guests.
There are no other guests. Just you and me. I'm in love with you. Surely you know that.
No. I'm the wrong guy for you. You need a big shot. Someone with polo ponies. A Valentino.
What you're saying is, you don't want me to love you. Is that it?
Max! Get me a taxi. I had to get out. I needed to be with people my own age, to hear the sound of laughter and mix with hungry actors, underemployed composers, nicotine poison writers, real people, real problems, having a really good time.
Let me take your coat. Woo, Jesus, Joe, what is this? Mink? Who'd you borrow this from? Adolf Manju?
Close, but no cigar. That's quite a crown.
I invited all the kids during walk-ons. And Samson and Delilah.
Hey, I'm glad you came. I want to talk to you.
Uh-oh.
You gotta say your New Year's resolutions out loud.
By this.
My 1950 will be my start.
start, nor my carrying spirit.
I'll be discovered. My life won't ever be the same. Billy Wilder will know my name, and he'll call all the time.
Till he does, can one of you guys lend her a dime?
Just an apartment with no roaches and no dry rot, where the hot water comes out hot. That's my Hollywood dream.
You're right.
But you'll get rewritten even after you're dead. It's a year to begin a new life by a place somewhere quiet, somewhere pretty. When you have a young kid and a wife, then you need somewhere green far from the city. It's a rambling old house with a big apple tree, with a swing for the kid and a hammock for me.
Behold my children. It is I, Cecily DeMille. Meeting me must be quite a thrill.
But there's no need to kneel.
I guarantee you, every girl in my chorus line is a genuine Philistine.
They don't come off the shelf.
I flew everyone in from Philistia myself. Presenting Samson and Delilah, coming shortly to a theater near you. See Samson conquer the mighty lion. See Samson unmanned by the voluptuous Delilah. Samson pulled down the temple of the Philistines! Now my next project, it's called The Greatest Show on Earth.
$3.6 million!
That's the strongest in sex!
How's your next project?
Sheldrake's anxious to option it. I've a feeling he smells a hit. We've got so much to do.
Betty, you're forgetting that I gave it to you. You remind me of me long ago, off the bus full of ignorant ambition. Thought I'd waltz into some studio and achieve overnight recognition. But an audience thinks when it's watching the screen that the actors make up every word in the scene.
Speak on the telephone. All my evenings are free.
Hey, just a minute. I'm the fella who bought the ring.
Artie, this is a business thing. It's important to me. You'll be on location in Clinch, Tennessee. Please make this your New Year resolution for me.
You know, I think I will be available in the new year. In fact, I'm available right now. Where's your phone?
Under the bar.
Hey, listen. Can you put me up for a couple weeks?
Well, it just so happens we got a vacancy on the couch.
I'll take it. I'll take it. Yeah, Max, this is Mr. Gillis. Listen, I want you to do me a favor.
I'm sorry, I cannot talk now, Mr. Gillis.
Listen, I want you to get my old suitcase.
I'm sorry, I am attending to Madame.
What do you mean?
Madame found the razor in your room, and she cut her wrists.
What's the matter? Joe.
Hey.
What's wrong?
Hey, Joe?
Go away. What kind of a silly thing was that to do?
I'll do it again. I'll do it again. I'll do it again.
Attractive headline. Great star kills herself for unknown writer.
Great stars have great pride. You must have some girl. Why don't you go to her?
I never meant to hurt you.
No.
You've been good to me. You're the only person in a stinking town that's ever been good to me.
Then why don't you say thank you and go? Go! Go!
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Darling.
Sure, I came out here to make my name. Wanted my pool, my dose of fame. Wanted my parking space at Warner's. But after a year, a one-room hell, a Murphy bed, a rancid smell, wallpaper peeling at the corners. Sunset Boulevard, twisting boulevard, secretive and rich, a little scary. Sunset Boulevard, tempting boulevard, waiting there to swallow the unwary. Dreams are not enough to win a war. Out here they're always keeping score. Beneath the tan, the battle rages. Smile, a rented smile, fill someone's glass. Kiss someone's wife, kiss someone's ass. We do it, ever pays the wages. Sunset Boulevard, headline boulevard. Getting here is only the beginning. Sunset Boulevard, jackpot boulevard. Once you won, you have to go on winning. You think I've sold out, dead right, I've sold out. I've just been waiting for the right offer. Comfortable quarters, regular rations, 24-hour, 5-star room service. And if I'm honest, I like the lady. I can't help being touched by her body. I'm treading water, taking up money, watching her sunset. Well, I'm a writer. L.A.'s changed a lot over the years since those brave gold rush pioneers came in their creaky covered wagons. Far as they could go, end of the line. Their dreams were yours, their dreams were mine. But in those dreams were hidden dragons. Sunset Boulevard, frenzied boulevard, swamped with every kind of false emotion. Sunset Boulevard, brutal boulevard, just like you will wind up in the ocean. She was sinking fast, I threw a rope. Now I have suits and she has hope. It seemed an elegant solution. One day this must end and isn't real. Still I'll enjoy a hearty meal before tomorrow's execution. Sunset Boulevard, ruthless boulevard, destination for the stony-hearted. Sunset Boulevard, lethal boulevard, everyone's forgotten how they started. Here on Sunset Boulevard.
There's been a call. What did I say? They want to see me right away. Joe Paramount, they love our child. Mr. DeMille is going wild.
That's wonderful, Norma.
But it was some fool assistant. Not acceptable at all. If he wants me, then Cecil B. himself must call.
No, I don't think this is the time to stand on ceremony.
What's a few more days, my dear? I told you so. It's happened, Joe. The perfect year.
Let's go upstairs.
Shouldn't you at least call back?
No. They can wait until I'm good and ready.
It took her 3 days and she was ready. She checked with her astrologer, who sacrificed a chicken. She dressed up like a pharaoh, slept on a pound of makeup, and set forth in her chariot. Poor Norma, so happy, re-entering her kingdom.
Thank you, Max.
Thank you.
to see Mr. DeMille. Open the gate.
Mr. DeMille is shooting. You need an appointment.
This is Norma Desmond. No appointment is necessary.
Norma who?
Jonesy.
Why, if it isn't Miss Desmond. Well, how have you been, Miss Desmond?
Fine, Jonesy. Open the gate.
You aren't Miss Desmond.
But they don't have a pass.
Stage 18, Miss Desmond.
Thank you, Jonesy. And teach your friends some manners. Tell him without me, there wouldn't be any Paramount Studio.
Give me stage 18. I have a message for Mr. DeMille.
Mr. DeMille?
What is it?
Norma Desmond is here to see you.
Norma Desmond?
She's here at the studio.
Must be about that appalling script of hers. What shall I say?
Maybe I could give her the brush.
30 million fans have given her the brush. Isn't that enough? I'll be right back.
Won't you come along, darling?
It's your script. It's your show. Good luck.
Thank you, darling. Hello, Mr. DeMille. Last time I saw you was someplace terribly gay. I was dancing on a table.
A lot of people were. Lindbergh had just landed.
Oh. You read the script, of course.
Well,
now, I know how busy you are when you're shooting, but I really think you could have picked up the phone yourself instead of leaving it to some assistant.
I don't know what you mean, Norm.
Oh, yes, you do.
Come on in.
Tony!
Look, it's so wonderful to see you again. You look so well.
Thank you.
Can you just check the
seat? Yeah.
Did you check the plan?
Sit over there in my chair, my dear. I'm just setting up a shot. Take it easy. You look up.
I know my way around here. The cardboard trees, the painted seas, the sound here. Yes, a world to rediscover. But I'm not in any hurry. And I need a moment. The whisper. Conversations in overcrowded hallways. The atmosphere as thrilling here as always. Feel the early morning madness.
trying to resist you. I'm trembling now, you can't know how I've missed you. Miss the fairy tale adventures in this ever-spinning playground. We were young together. I'm coming out of makeup. The light's already burning. Yes, everything's as if we never said goodbye. I don't want to be alone. That's all in the past. This world's waited long enough. I've come home at last. And this time will be bigger. Not just today, but always.
Meeting.
Where have you been keeping yourself?
Someone's been doing it for me.
We should talk.
Gotta run.
Holding Joe, I can't write this on my own. I thought you said you'd help me.
I'm really sorry, New Year crisis. Would you believe a sick friend? It's just not a good time, not right now.
Well, when is a good time?
I will call you, I promise.
I guess I'll have to trust you.
Thanks. I won't let you down.
Don't you work for Norma Desmond? A couple of weeks ago, I was looking out of my office window and I saw you driving the lot, and I said, that is exactly the car I've been looking for. Great for my Crosby picture. So I made some inquiries and I've been calling for 2 weeks. Doesn't she ever answer the phone?
Go away.
It's so perfect. You don't find that kind of thing outside of a museum. And we'll pay. I plan to offer her $100 a week.
Don't you dare speak to her. Go away.
What are you, crazy?
It's just not a good time. Not right now.
Did you see?
how they all came crowding around. They still love me and soon will be breaking new ground. Great violin,
those were the days,
just like before
we had such fun.
We gave the world new ways to dream.
We always found new ways to dream. Let's have a good long talk one day.
The old team will be back in business.
Sorry. My next shot's ready.
Gillis.
What's the matter, Max?
I just found out the reason for all those phone calls from Paramount. It's not Madame they want. It's her car.
Jesus Christ.
Now you remember, don't you? I don't work before 10 or after 4:30 in the afternoon.
It isn't entirely my decision, Norma. New York must be consulted.
That's fine. You ask any exhibitor in the country. I'm not forgotten.
Of course you're not. Goodbye, young fellow. We'll see what we can do.
Oh, I'm not worried. It's so wonderful to be back.
Really, Norma Desmond?
It was.
She must be about a million years old.
I hate to think where that puts me. I could be her father.
I'm sorry, Mr. DeMille.
If you could have seen her at 17, when all of her dreams were new,
they don't know each other. He works the night shift and she takes classes all day. Here's the thing, they both share the same name, sleep in the same bed, it works out cheaper that way.
Well, I've a feeling you're just kidding, but to me it sounds believable. Makes a better opening than that car. Sleeping or at her sewing machine.
Some real possibilities here.
Who's Norma?
Who's who?
I'm sorry. I don't usually read private cigarette cases.
Norma's a friend of mine, a middle-aged lady. Very foolish, very generous.
I'll say. This is solid gold. Mad about the boy?
How's Artie?
Stuck in Tennessee. It rains all the time. They're weeks behind. Nobody knows when they'll get back.
Good.
What's good about it? I'm missing him something fierce.
Oh, no. No, I mean, this idea we had is really pretty good. Back to work.
What if he's a teacher?
Where does that get us? Don't see what good that would do.
No, it's great if they do the same job.
So much in common.
little scenes in the factory.
Not if he's a champion for the working man. The girl likes boy, she respects his talent.
Working with someone can turn you into a fan.
This is fun, writing with a partner.
Yes, and it could be.
Eternal youth is worth a little suffering. Of course, there's bound to be a little suffering. Eternal youth is worth a little suffering. Of course, there's bound to be a little suffering. Eternal youth is worth a little suffering.
Is this what you're looking for by any chance?
Why, yes.
Whose number is this? I was worried about the line of my throat, but this woman has done wonders with it.
Good.
And I've lost a half a pound since Tuesday.
Very good.
And now it's after 9. I'd better go to bed.
You had.
Are you coming up?
I think I'll read a little longer.
You went out last night, didn't you, Joe?
I went out for a walk.
You took the car.
I drove to the beach.
Who's Betty Schaefer?
Surely you don't want me to feel like I'm a prisoner in this house.
You don't understand, Joe. I'm under a terrible strain. It has been so hard, I even got myself a revolver. The only thing that stopped me from using it was the thought of all of those people waiting to see me back on the screen.
Norma.
How could I disappoint them? All I ask is a little patience, a little understanding.
Norma, there's nothing to worry about. I haven't done anything.
Oh, of course you haven't. Good night, Dan.
I should have stayed there. poor Norma, so desperate to be ready for what would never happen, but Betty would be waiting. We had the script to finish, one unexpected love scene, two people both risking a kind of happy ending.
T-H-E-E-N-D. I can't believe it! I finished my first script!
Stop it! You're making me feel old.
It's exciting, though, isn't it?
How old are you, anyway?
22.
Smart girl.
Shouldn't we open some champagne?
Best I can offer is a stroll to the water cooler at the end of the lot.
Sounds good to me. I love the back lot here. All cardboard, all hollow. All phony, all done with mirrors. I think I love it better than any street in the world. I spent my childhood here.
What? Were you a child actress?
No, but my family always expected me to become a great star. I had 10 years of dramatic lessons, diction, dancing, everything you could think of. Then the studio made a test.
Oh, that's the saddest story I've ever heard.
Come on. Electrician at the studio until he died. My mother still works in wardrobe.
Second generation, huh?
Third. Grandma did stunt work for Pearl White.
I guess it is kind of exciting at that, finishing a script.
What?
You all right?
Sure.
Something's the matter, isn't it?
I had a telegram from Artie.
Is there something wrong?
He wants me to come out to Tennessee. He says it would only cost $2 to get married in Clinch.
Well, what's stopping you? Now we've finished the script. Why are you crying? You're getting married, isn't that what you wanted?
Not anymore.
Don't you love Artie?
Of course I do. Not in love with him anymore, that's all.
Why not? What happened?
You did? When I was a kid, I played on the street. I always loved illusion. I thought make-believe was truer than life. But now it's all confusion. Please, can you tell me what's happening? I just don't know anymore. If this is
smart, you would keep on walking out of my life as fast as you can. I'm not the one you should pin your hopes on. You're falling for the wrong kind of man. This is crazy. You know we should call it a day. Sound advice, great advice. Let's throw it away. I can't control all the things I'm feeling. I haven't got a prayer. If I'm a fool, well, I'm too much in love to care. I knew where I was, I'd given up hope. Made friends with disillusion. No one in my life, but I look at you, and now it's all confusion.
Please, can you tell me what's happening? I just don't know anymore. If this is real, how should I feel? What should I look for?
What's the matter there, Max? You waiting to wash the car?
Please, be careful when you cross the patio. Madame may be watching.
Suppose I tiptoe up the back stairs and undress in the dark. Will that do it?
It's just that I am greatly worried about Madame.
Well, we're not helping her any. It's feeding her lies and more lies.
happens when she finds out they're not gonna make her picture?
She never will. That is my job. I made her a star, and I will never let her be destroyed.
Max, you made her a star?
I directed all her early pictures. In those days, there were three young directors who showed promise. E.W. Griffith, Cecil B. DeMille, and...
Max von Meyerling.
That's right. When we met, she was a child, barely 16. Awkward, and yet she had an air I'd never seen. I knew I'd found my perfect face. Deep in her eyes, new ways to dream. And we inspired new ways to dream. Talkies came, I stayed with her, took off this life, threw away fame. Please understand, she was my wife. We had achieved far more than most. We gave the world new ways to dream. Everyone needs new ways to dream.
Are you telling me you were married to her?
I was the first husband.
Hello, is this Gladstone 9281? Miss Schaefer. Miss Schaefer, you must forgive me for calling so late, but I really feel it's my duty. It's about Mr. Gillis. You do know a Mr. Gillis. Well, exactly how much do you know about him? Do you know where he lives? Do you know what he lives on? I want to spare you a lot of sadness. I don't know what he's told you, but I can guarantee you he doesn't live with mother, or what you'd call a roommate. He's just a... I can't say it. Poor Benny. You ask him. I'd like to hear his answer.
That's right, Betty. Why don't you ask me? Now, better yet, come and see for yourself. Yes, right now. The address is 10,086 Sunset Boulevard.
Oh, don't hate me, Joe. I did it because I need you. Look at me. Look at my hands. Look at my face. Look under my eyes. How can I go back to work if I'm wasting away? Don't stand there hating me, Joe. Shout at me. Strike me, but say you don't hate me. Please say you don't hate me. No, Joe.
Come on in.
What's going on, Joe? Why am I so scared? What was that woman saying? She sounded so weird. I don't understand. Please, can you tell me what's happening? Don't you love me anymore? Shall I just go? Say something, Joe.
Have some pink champagne and caviar. When you go visit with a star, the hospitality is stellar.
So this is where you're living?
Yes, it's quite a place. Sleep 17, 8 sunken tubs, a movie screen, a bowling alley in the cellar.
I didn't come to see a house, Joe.
Sunset Boulevard, cruise the boulevard. When you'll have a Hollywood palazzo. Sunset Boulevard, Mythic Boulevard. Valentino danced on that terrazzo.
Who's it belong to?
Just look around you.
That's Norma Desmond.
Right on the money. That's Norma Desmond. That's Norma Desmond. That's Norma Desmond. That's Norma Desmond.
Why did she call me?
Give you three guesses. It's the oldest story in the book. Come see the taker being took. The world is full of Joes and Normas. Older woman, very well to do. Meets younger man, a standard cue for two mechanical performers.
Just pack your things.
Things, have you gone mad? Leave all these things I've never had. Leave this luxurious existence. You are made of face, that one room hell, that Murphy bed, that wretched smell. Go back to living on subsistence. There's no time to begin a new life. Now I finally made a perfect landing. I'm afraid there's no room for a wife, not unless she's uniquely understanding. You should go back to Artie and marry the fool, and you'll always be welcome to swim in my pool.
I can't look at you anymore, Joe. Thank you, Joe. Thank you. What are you doing, Joe? You're not leaving me.
Yes, I am, Norma.
No, you can't! Max! Max!
It's been a bundle of laughs. And thanks for the use of the trinkets. A little pretty for the copy desk back in Dayton. And there's something you should know. I want to do you this favor. They'll never shoot that hopeless script of yours. They only wanted your car.
That's a lie. They still want me. What about all my fan mail?
It's Max who writes your letters.
has vanished. They left when you weren't looking. Nothing's wrong with being 50! Unless you're acting 20.
Star of them all.
Goodbye, Norma.
No one ever leaves a star. They're bringing his head on a silver tray. She kisses his mouth. She kisses his mouth. She kisses his mouth. Mad about the boy.
Let me. Madame, the cameras have arrived.
Max, where am I?
This is the staircase of the palace, and they're waiting for you.
Of course, now I remember I was so frightened I might fall.
You are the greatest star. Lights! Cameras! Action!
insane. I'm too happy. May I say a few words, Mr. DeMille? I can't tell you how wonderful it is to be back in the studio making a picture. I promise you, I will never desert you again. And now I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille. This is my life. It always will be. There is nothing else. Just us. The cameras. And all you wonderful people out there in the dark.
Do you have another bag, please?